So welcome to Makeup by Melanie's tutorial on how to create the cat eye using just shadows.
This is a great alternative instead of using the liquid or gel liners to create a cat eye look.
With Halloween right around the corner and everyone planning Halloween parties and gatherings, this might be a look that you want to consider for that next party. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have fun creating your cat eye look. Let's get started. So the first thing you want to do is prime your lids. I'm using Too Faced Shadow Insurance to make sure that the eyeshadow that I put on lasts for a good while. Only use one dot for each eye, spread evenly across your eyelid, and don't forget the bottom of your lashes, since for this look we'll be putting shadow at the bottom as well. Next, grab a brush with a round dome, such as this one, and use it to measure the cat eye that you will be creating. Pull the brush along the natural curve of your lower lash to measure out that cat eye that you'll be creating with the shadow. For this look, I'm using a matte gray shadow such as this one. And I will begin to pat the shadow on top of my eyelid. Again, just pat. You don't want to drag the shadow across your lid for fallout reasons. I go ahead and pat it on since I've made my mental picture of where I want my cat eye to look like. So just drag out the shadow so we can begin that process. Sweep that shadow in a downward motion to create your cat eye. Again, you want to follow the lower lash line and be sure you connect your cat eye with your current shadow on your eyelid. Now, if you need to, go back in and pack more of your eyeshadow onto your lid. You want to be sure that you can't see your skin tone. Now clean off that same brush and use a medium brown to trace along the gray that you've already put on your lid. You want to blend slightly. You don't want to blend too much, just so you don't lose that form that you've already created. We just want to take away some of the harsh lines. If you need to, use a little bit more of that medium brown for continued blending. Still keeping that shape of the cat eye. Don't expect immediate results, so just take some time and some patience. Keep looking and double checking. Next, take a flat brush, such as this one, and what we're gonna do is begin the highlight. And the highlight that I'm using is another matte color. It's more of a flesh tone, maybe about close to 3 shades lighter than my current skin color. So what I do is I just try to highlight part closest to my nose, so before the arch of the eyebrow. I choose to concentrate the highlight before the arch of my eyebrow just to enhance the cat eye effect. And using a smudge brush, such as this one from Sephora, you want to apply that same gray matte shadow as you did on your lid and put it along the lower lash line. For this look, I'm only going to put it on maybe the first half of my lower lash line. Be sure you connect the shadow from the cat eye that you've already created through the lower lash line. Using that same smudge brush, I took a shimmery medium to light gray shadow to put on the rest of my lower lash line, working from my tear duct to blend towards the matte gray that I've already put on. Man, I don't understand your ways. Living on the edge. Blend the two colors as best as you can. You want there to be a nice smooth transition from color to color. Using that same flat brush from earlier, go ahead and find a really light shimmery gray shadow, and we'll go ahead and apply this at the inner corner of our eyes, right by the tear ducts. This adds a nice little highlight and sparkle to your cat eye. ahead and find a black liner. This is from Sephora. This black liner is actually really smooth and waterproof. Because of this look, I'm not going to use any mascara on my lower lash. I want the emphasis to be towards the cat eye. I think too much lash just takes away from that. Now it's time to curl the lashes. Even though I'm not going to put mascara on my lower lash, I do want to make sure my lashes are flirty. I'll be using CoverGirl Exact Eye Lights for brown eyes. The color is Black Pearl, and it really does have a pearlized effect. Make sure you put enough coats, and don't forget, don't put any mascara on your lower lash line. You want to skip that part. Now it's time to conceal. This is Smashbox in 4.0. Take your ring finger and swirl around the top of the product. The heat of my finger will melt it, making it easier for application. And simply just start dotting around your eye area and getting as close to the lash line as possible. If you don't feel comfortable using your fingertip, then you might want to consider using a concealer brush for this step. And now for one of my favorite products, loose powder by Too Faced, called Primed and Poreless. This stuff is awesome. Take a little bit of the product on the inside cover and swirl your powder brush just along the inside. Be sure you tap off any of the excess product. What I'll do is just concentrate powder along my T-zone. I tend to get pretty shiny around my nose and my forehead and chin area. Dab on as much as you need. This has a really nice, soft effect. For blush, I'll be using this brush from Sephora. The color that I've picked is this nice bright pink color. Instead of just putting on the apples of my cheeks, I like to bring the color all the way up alongside my cheekbone and stay right on the cheekbone. We're going to use a highlight color here in a second. This lighter shimmery color I'll add just along the apple of my cheekbone and staying along the upper portion of my cheekbone, up around the corner of my eye to the temple area. When the light hits your cheek, it creates this nice luminous glow. It's very pretty. Now it's time to finish off the look with a nice pink color lip gloss. Using a lip brush, I apply the lip gloss on my lower lip first. I don't use any liner here because I want it to be as clean as possible. A tip for lining your upper lip: begin at the crease of your mouth and working your way upwards towards your Cupid's bow. This just helps an unsteady hand. And then we're finished. This is the final look, ladies. I hope you enjoy this tutorial and that you bring out your inner kitten. See you soon. Bye.